Hey, what is going on everybody? It is Nolan, or the Optimistic Gamer here, and welcome back to another build tutorial. Today we are building the smelting factory that we built in the Optimistic Survival series not too long ago. It's pretty simple, but lots of detail hidden within. Let's get started on the materials. It is a pretty simple set, at least for the exterior. Once we get to the interior furnace layout, it gets a little bit more complex with all of our redstone wiring, and you can see this build is partially finished, but ours will be 100%. So we are using anvils, cauldrons, hoppers, and pointed dripstone for some detailing. We are using deep slate bricks, stairs, slabs, and walls for the build. Red nether bricks, slabs, and walls as well. Tough bricks, tough walls for the chimneys, and then crimson stems, crimson planks, and cherry wood for the upstairs walls. And finally, just for some extra added detail, red candles, and then the windows and doors, mangrove, and white stained glass panes. Find out where you want to build this. I'm going to be placing it right here, and we will start with our deep slate bricks and our red nether brick walls. Start with the front left corner and place an inverted L shape right here, so the walls will be here and here. Place a red nether brick wall right there, and then go one block back and place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then leave a two block gap. Excuse me, break that one block, so 7 walls, leave a two block gap, and then place 7 more walls right there, and then a deep slate brick next to it, and we are going to make another L shape and one more nether brick wall right there. To know that you have lined it up, place a wall adjacent to the deep slate bricks, leave a one block gap, place another wall, and a one block gap, place another wall, one more gap, and place another wall. We should have 3 one block gaps right here. Again, each of these wall sections are 7 blocks in length. We can wreck these walls right here next to that two block gap and replace those with nether bricks, 3 blocks tall, just like this. In between those, we can place some upside down deep slate stairs. Moving around to the side right here, we will place, this needs to move forward by one more block. So move everything forward so the back of that L is right there. That's how it should look from above. And then we can place our walls adjacent on that inside block right here, going towards the back for a total of 11. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. All right, this is me from the future cutting in because I realized I messed up my build. So right here, we want this to be 9 blocks in length. So we want to only have 4 windows and a gap right here in the middle. So this should be the middle of the build. And then this corner will start right here. That's just me cutting in, and now I will be back. But just so you know, all of the recording that you are about to watch with me building all of this, it will be 5 blocks, but just know that is not correct, or excuse me, 5 windows, know that that is not correct, and I'm about to fix it, and then everything will be good to go. And then do that same pattern once again, with the L shape just like that, and a wall in that corner, and then we will extend these walls on the inside of those bricks until they are lined up with those walls over there, and we will do another L shape, nether brick in the corner, and then just connect these on the inside like that. So from up above, it looks like this. Now we are going to extend each of these corners up for a total of 5 blocks. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We will extend all of the deep slate bricks and the nether brick walls in the corners. We can do that 4 times. And that will now be looking like this. Let's go ahead and work on our front facade here. With these walls, we can extend these up to the height of the bricks in the corners, and we will place a row of red nether bricks going all the way across the top, just like that. We will then extend these walls going up, so we have some 3 block tall windows right here, and we will place 4 walls on top of the 2 stairs and 2 brick blocks that we have right there. Take out your white stained glass panes and your mangrove doors and we can fill in these gaps right here with our panes, and in the 2-block gap from the inside, our mangrove doors, just like that. So let's go ahead and detail the front a little bit. Grab out your anvils, your cauldrons, your deep slate brick walls, and your hoppers. Place a row of anvils sideways going across the front, just like this, so that the tops are connected. In between all of the windows, right on top of the anvil, we are going to place 2 deep slate brick walls going up. On top of those walls, we will place hoppers facing into the walls. And all across next to these bricks up here, we will place a row of cauldrons, and that is going to give us some of these nice detailed arches right there, but also showing the color of the red nether bricks behind it. We are going to repeat this facade 3 more times, so here on the side, we will have the 1-block gaps once again, and we will have 5 windows with 1 in the middle. Same thing over here on this other short side. And here in the back, we will follow the same pattern with our walls, 1-block gaps until we get to the middle, where we will have a 2-block gap, and then a 1-block gap everywhere else. We will then extend the walls across the top row, just like this, all the way around, and extend those up, fill the gaps in with our white stained glass panes, and continue that same pattern with the anvils on the bottom, the walls placed 2 blocks on top, the hoppers on top of the walls, and the cauldrons lining the top row. And once you have finished that, the sides and the back should be looking like this. Once again, we have that 2-block window right here. Same pattern with our cauldrons across the top and the hoppers and walls on each side. We are pretty much finished with the first floor at this point, other than the floor inside, and we can actually grab out some polished tuff to fill that in. And of course, make sure you fill in under the walls as well, because that will be visible from the inside also. So with our floor in place, it is time to start working on the roof right here. To begin, go to either side and find the middle hopper, or the middle cauldron right here, and place 2 deep slate bricks on top of it. Extend this to either side until all of the cauldrons are covered. Same thing over here on this side. Find the middle window right here, 2 bricks on top of it, and place the rest of them, 1 layer covering the cauldrons, just like that. Next, with our nether brick slabs, we are going to place a single row of these on the top half of all the cauldrons going all the way around, just like that. So sticking 1 block out from the cauldrons on that top half, and we should have a red nether brick slab perimeter going all the way around the build. Let's work on the curved shape right here. Line up with the wall on the short side right here, and place a slab on top of it. Extend that forward by 1, and then up by 1, and then forward by 1, and up by 1. And then go forward once again, and go down underneath it, so we have a sort of full block look right there. Extend that out again, and up by 1, out again, and down by 1, once again, 2 more full blocks. And then out by 1 and up by 1. Alright, my apologies for all of that. I just need to fix a couple things here. So this should be lined up in the middle, right above that pillar, but our 4 bricks will still be on either side covering all of the cauldrons. That's a lot better, and now we can redo this. So we will go up right here next to that wall, and then out, up, out, up, and then another block next to that, and then out and up, another block next to that, and now here at the top, we should be able to place 1 there in the middle. Same thing right over here, so we will have this perimeter, which I forgot to fill in. Lined up with the wall, we will place a slab right there, go in and up, and then a full block right there, and then 2 more blocks, just like that. So we get this really nice curved shape. We can do that same thing over here on this side. There we go, simple as that. For the roof, we are going with our deep slate brick slabs, and we can start to fill these going all the way across, connecting our nether brick slabs on either side. but we are only going to do the first two rows on each side because some of these will get destroyed anyway to compensate for the second floor, and we are going to have a somewhat large gap in the middle of the roof right here where that will be. But for now, go ahead and take out your dripstone. This is optional. I kind of like how it looks, but you don't have to do this. And I'm going to place a row of dripstone facing up on top of all of those red nether brick slabs, just like that. Of course, it will be sort of different alignment every time, which makes this building unique in that sense, which I really like about that. We can do the same thing around here on the back as well, if we want. And I like how that looks, so we will go with that. It even kind of parts here in the middle, which is extra nice. So, now that we have that, it is time to start working on the second floor. This is nice and simple. Go ahead and grab out some red nether bricks. And we do actually need red nether brick stairs. I forgot about those. So grab those out as well. Line yourself up with the hoppers on either side of the front door and break 1, 2, 3, and 4 from each hopper going across the middle. Place 2 red nether brick stairs facing each other like that and 2 slabs in between them. On the outsides of those stairs, break those slabs and place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 red nether bricks going up. Then go one block above these right here, and we are going to go back 1, 2, 3 and over 1, 2, and then we can wreck those 4 blocks right there and build that pillar up to the height of those pillars. And then leave a 5 block gap, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then do the same thing once again with our pillars going up to the top. We can extend that down by 1 as well. So right now, that is how that is looking. We have, again, I will place some blocks here so it is easy to see. We have a 4 block space that is sort of turned right here before we get to that pillar. And these are 5 blocks in between them. These are 4 blocks in between them, and we are going to do the same pattern going all the way around. So we will go back 1, 2, 3 and out 1, and then extend our red nether bricks up to the height of that first pillar right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then again extending our red nether bricks up to the height of those pillars. And then right around here on the backside, this is nice and easy. Just find these slabs and we can line ourselves up with that side and place down our nether bricks. Just like that. And then these 4 slabs in the middle, break them and replace them with 2 stairs facing inside and 2 slabs just like that. Extend these up to the height of those pillars. We can also break these 4 slabs that are visible from the stairs and red nether brick slabs that we have on the outside. And now we can start to fill in the walls. The easiest way to do this is take your crimson planks and place a row next to these stairs and slabs right here in the front and the back. Just like that. And then going up diagonally on either side, we can place 2 more crimson planks on each side, extend that back by 1, and then turn it so it is diagonal going into that next pillar, just like that on all sides. So from up above, it should look like this. We will now connect these slabs going all the way across, just like that. And we will extend all of these planks up to the height of the red nether bricks. So we will have something looking like this. Now that those walls are in place, we can go ahead and finish our roof. Again, lining ourselves up with the nether brick slabs right here. We are just going to trace that shape and fill in these slabs until they are touching that second floor right there. So they will connect to the walls. Just like that, and we will do that on both sides. There we go. So now our first floor roof is finished, and our second floor is almost complete. We will do the chimneys last. Let's go ahead and work on the roof for the second floor. This is going to be very similar to our first floor roof and pretty simple. So find the top half of these blocks up here, and we are going to make 4 L shapes in each of these corners. And that is with our slabs on the upper half. So from up above, it looks like that, and they will look like they are connected to those blocks. Extend them out by one on each side, just like that, and then connect them going across. Future me interjecting again. Don't place those rows of slabs connecting to them. Go ahead and get rid of those. You're gonna see that I have it when I do that first pattern, but get rid of them. They should just stick out like this. So right here, line yourself up with that pillar and place a slab, extend it out by one and up by one, out and up, and then over here, up by one, and then out, and up. So in the front, we will have something that looks like this. All right, there, had to fix that again, but we are all good. So we will have that curved roof, and then on this side, it's gonna be a little longer. So we are going to go out, up, out, up, out, up, out, up, and then on this side, out, up, out, up, out, and up, just like that. We will repeat that on these two sides as well. There we go, and now to fill in the roof, all we have to do is take our deep slate brick slabs and start to fill these in, connecting all of these slabs, and we will turn them when they are on the same level. Since this side is a little bit shorter, it will not go all the way across, it will instead connect to that row that goes across on the long side, and then we will extend these all the way across the top on the long side. And then once we get back down one more row, these will connect on this side, and we will have something that looks like that. And then again, we will just fill in the rest of it with our slabs, connecting all of the red nether brick slabs in each corner. And that will look like that. So now we can add in some windows. We can also fill in these gaps right up here with our planks on top. Place two in the middle, three on this side, just like that, two over here, and three more on this side. And we still have a few more lingering gaps. Take out your deep slate brick slabs and fill those in so that they are on the same level as the red nether brick slabs. We will do that for those four as well, and we will do that on all sides. And there we go, the roof is now finished for both levels. Now we need to add in some windows on the second floor. Go to the front, go one full block up, we have these half blocks right here, and then a full block, and then right here, above those full blocks, rec 1, 2, 3, and 4, we will have a 4-block tall window. We will do the exact same thing over here on this side, so you can just break a couple of blocks in the middle, get yourself lined up, and just like that. So we have 1.5 blocks here, and 1.5 blocks there. A nice centered window. And then on the sides here, we are going to have two windows, leaving these middle blocks alone. Go to either side, and we are going to do a 3-block tall window with 1 block underneath them and 1.5 blocks above them. Same thing over here on this side. We can just line ourselves up with those windows over there. 2 3-block tall windows, so the top should be lined up with the top of the front window. We can fill those in with our white stained glass panes. So that is how that will look, but the top walls are looking a little bland and boring. That is where our crimson stems and our cherry wood will come into play. We are going to randomly sprinkle this in for a few blocks, replacing the crimson planks, and we can even place some of these stems going sideways, and we will fill those in until we have a pretty organic shape to that, and it will really break up some of those planks. And just like that, not much to it, just kind of randomly placing those blocks, it breaks up those crimson planks and makes the upper part of this build a lot more detailed, and it looks a little bit more weathered as well. So now all that is left for the building itself is the chimney, or the two chimneys, I should say. And these are pretty simple. Go one block in from this red nether brick slab and wreck that first deep slate slab. And we can replace that with tough bricks, just placed in a plus pattern like that, going around. And then in the corners right here, we will place tough brick walls. The chimney is going to be 10 blocks tall, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And all of the tough bricks and the walls are going to be risen up to the height of 10 on both sides. There we go. If you want to place some campfires and hay bales underneath those in the chimneys, go for it. Uh-oh, it looks like I missed a wall right here. We will get that real quick. And just like that, the building itself is finished. I guess we could add our candles though real quick. We are going to place these on the anvils in front of the windows here. You can do this on all sides if you want, just to really light the build. I am going to place them on the front, alternating anvils. So we are going to leave the middle window right there open, but I'm still going to place 4 candles and grab some flint and steel and get those lit. There we go. So we have 4 sets of candles, 16 in total. Just like that. It is now time to work on the interior, and boy does it need some work. We can start up here. Actually, we will start with our ceiling, so we can take our deep slate brick slabs, or if you would rather use something else for the ceiling, you can use that as well. And we are just going to place these so that they are one block or one half slab above the nether brick walls right here. And we will just place a perimeter going all the way around. You don't have to worry about the gaps that are left up above there because these are half slabs and they aren't tall enough. These spaces aren't tall enough to spawn mobs anyway. But we can also go ahead and fill in these gaps above the walls. And if you are using something other than these deep slate brick slabs, these gaps will probably have to be slabs, or you could place full blocks for the ceiling right here above the window. Your walls will still connect. You will still have those gaps, so you may want to fill them in anyway. But because you cannot stack slabs of different materials, you will probably have to go with the deep slate brick slabs for these gaps right here. And we will have a little bit of the upstairs wall showing. That's okay. It doesn't bother me a whole lot. And we will fill this in going all the way across until we have one nice and flat ceiling right inside. There we go. And of course, our second floor exists upstairs. We will tackle that here in a moment. And now it is time to work on our furnace mechanism. So we will need some furnaces and blast furnaces, redstone blocks, hoppers, hopper minecarts, levers, powered and normal rails, and some smooth stone or block of your choice. Leave a 3 block gap in front of the door and then place 2 smooth stone just like that and extend it all the way to the back window. Again, the walls will connect, but they are hidden by the anvil, so you won't really be able to tell from the outside. On top of these front 2 stone, place 2 more just like that, and we can place our levers on top of those. Right behind those, a powered rail, and then 2 more rails going like that. They will connect, and you might have to do a little bit of work, maybe 1 at a time, and then place another powered rail just like that. So powered, normal, and then powered. We can also place a smooth stone going up right there. We can put our levers away and grab out our chests and then leave a 1 block gap right here in between the smooth stone and the chests, and we are going to place a large chest just like that with hoppers extending into them, 4 in total on each side. And these are placed on the side closer to the front wall. And then we will extend these going back, again, placing these hoppers into one another. And we will turn these right here in that corner as well. So we have this whole hopper chain with a 1 block gap between them and the wall, all feeding into the large chest. Same thing over here on this side. On top of all of these hoppers, we are going to place our furnaces and blast furnaces. So we can place 5 like that, and 5 like that. If you want to place one in the corner as well, you can. I like to maximize efficiency, so we will get one more right there. So 11 furnaces in total. If you want an even number, you can place 12 right there. But I'm gonna place 11 just for the sake of space. And actually, we can move these hoppers right here to the inside row of the chest. Same thing over here on this side, so we will turn these hoppers just like that. Next, behind all of the furnaces, we are going to place hoppers going into the sides. This is where our fuel is going to go. Same thing with the blast furnaces. And you can have two hoppers going into that corner furnace, or just one. It doesn't matter. Just make sure you place down some smooth stone as well. I like to place just one, then the glass doesn't connect that way. So we should have a setup that looks like this. We have two rows of hoppers, one underneath all of our furnaces, and one going into them. Our last step is one more row of hoppers on top of all of our furnaces and blast furnaces. All right, so we should now have our two rows of hoppers underneath the furnaces and the second row going into them. We are going to have two rows of minecarts placed on top of the furnaces and on top of the hoppers, just like that. Do powered rails on top of the hoppers, and here in the corners, we can do our normal rails and turn those just like that. Once we get here to the edge, we can turn the rails once again, and we can actually go ahead and replace that with a normal rail. We should have enough juice to get up that ramp right there, but we can also put a powered rail right there as well. As for the back, we are going to place two more smooth stone going across the back, and these powered rails are just going to continue all the way across to the other side, right back here, where we will have a smooth stone block keeping the minecarts from flying off the track. We will extend that out by two and all the way to the floor as well. Same thing over here on this side. And we can fill in the rest of these rails on top of these blast furnaces. So now we should have three separate tracks. We have this one right here for the blast furnaces, this one right here for the normal furnaces, and this one right here for our fuel. And actually, what we will do for our fuel loading is break these two blocks right here, and we will extend these rails going down in this direction right over here, and we will place one more stone right there, a powered rail right there, and we will just connect that up. So now we can load our fuel into here, whether it be lava buckets or something else. We can place one more lever here on the front, and when we add our lava into there, we can just place that and it will deliver all of our lava. Of course, it will get stuck on those powered rails, but we will see we now have lava in that blast furnace. So that will be where we load our lava. This will not include a lava farm in the world, I think I mentioned this, but our power plant next door is where we will have our lava dripstone for the fuel in here. But now you can power these rails, and the easiest way to do that is with a block of redstone placed on top of each one, on all rails right here. There we go. And we can go ahead and hide all of this construction with trap doors. So we will place these going across, and here in the corner, we can place another row of smooth stone going all the way to the ceiling. If you want to leave the furnaces visible, you certainly can, but we can place the rest of these in there now. Of course, the ones on the redstone blocks will close automatically. And once you get all of those closed up, I think we will leave the furnaces visible just so we can see what is happening. And that will look like this. You can even cover this up on this side if you want to as well, but that is really all there is to it. I didn't opt for a super advanced interior for this, just something basic. I was mainly focused on the look of the building from the outside, and I think we accomplished it quite well. But that is all for this tutorial today. If you enjoyed it, definitely hit that thumbs up button and make sure you are subscribed so you don't miss out on daily content as soon as I publish it. Check the description for some more important information, links, how to contact me, all of that good stuff. And with all of that being said, comment, like, subscribe, remember to stay optimistic, and I will see all of you tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Bye!